Project Protect presents
da, 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 da.
History of Antibiotics.
Did you know that the U.S. produces about 36 million pounds of antibiotics annually? 70% of all antibiotics are used in animal husbandry, and nearly 25 million pounds of these are used for non-therapeutic purposes, not for the treatment of human disease.
So, how did this all begin? The first traces of antibiotic use were found in areas such as Russia, Greece, and India when molds in plants were used to treat infections. Then in 1928, a scientist named Alexander Fleming discovered that he could kill certain strains of bacteria. This finding was just the beginning of worldwide antibiotic use. Fast forward to the golden age for antibiotic discovery during the 1950s to 1970s when new drugs emerged like streptomycin, chloramphenicol, and tetracycline. Half of the drugs used today were actually discovered during this golden age. One of the great achievements in antibiotic discovery was the synthesis of penicillin by MIT chemist John Sheehan. In 1942, the first patient was treated for strep using US-made penicillin. Then in the 1960s, methicillin was introduced, but 2 years later, strands of methicillin-resistant S. aureus known as MRSA appeared. Eventually, drug development began to slow down in the 1970s and 80s. Slowly, scientists began to realize that antibiotic use eventually led to antibiotic resistance. Even though these new drugs were being developed, the problem was that they closely resembled previously used antibiotics, and in a year, the bacteria would become resistant. So, what would happen if we can't find a solution to antibiotic resistance? Once bacteria become resistant to the majority of our antibiotics, bacterial infections will be just as dangerous as before. Even a minor scrape will increase your risk for infection. With that being said, many of the medical advances and surgeries that save lives will become unusable. Many medical procedures, which once required the use of antibiotics, will become dangerous. Tuberculosis is already multi-drug resistant and will become extremely multi-drug resistant, meaning that nothing will be able to cure it. Any bacteria with high antibiotic resistance will be incurable. Treatment will result in confining or isolating patients in a room until they recover or die. Ultimately, a world with irreversible antibiotic resistance will result in the loss of many lives. So what can you do about antibiotic resistance? Plenty of things, actually. Educate your friends and family. If you or your loved ones become ill, do not resort to going to the doctor right away for antibiotics. Find alternative methods to treating symptoms, such as higher intake of fruits and vegetables and getting more rest. Prevention is also a good way to avoid illness, such as washing your hands with regular soap and water. Wearing a mask can also help with preventing yourself from getting worse or passing bacteria to others. Most importantly, if you do find yourself taking antibiotics, ensure that you finish the entire prescription in order to kill off all bacterial colonies. If left unfinished, any remaining colonies will become resistant, therefore leaving the antibiotic ineffective. So help us spread the word about antibiotic resistance. If you liked our video, follow us on Facebook and Twitter, and don't forget to subscribe.